Okay, good morning to all of you. As we already discussed in last lecture regarding the industrial design, we have covered the basic requirements to register the industrial design. What are the different criteria are there? Or what is exactly design means? That we also discuss. What is design? So it is the feature of shape, configurations, patterns, ornaments, or any compositions of the lines and the color that is applied on an article, whether in a 2D or in a 3D form, and that will be appealed to the eyes, and that is solely judged by the eyes. So it is the simple definitions of design that we have discussed in the last lectures. Today we'll talk about the registration process, how the registrations of design takes place in India. What are the steps involved, what are the precautions that you have to take place, or what are the requirements for the registrations also, means how to draft your claims, or all those things that we are going to discuss in today's lecture. So just let me So before that, can anyone tell me what is the term for industrial design? Like a patent, it is a 20 years. What is the term for industrial design? Yes, anyone? Or why to register a design? What are the benefits of registering the designs under the Industrial Design Act? What is the Year of Design Act? When it is implemented or when it comes in force? Yes, anyone? Avaaz yetoy maza?
Yes, sir.
If I ask something, what is the Year of Design Act and when it comes into force with effect for? This question they will ask for CPAT also. The Year of your Design Act and when it comes into force. So the Design Act, that is 2000, and it comes in force effective from 11th May 2001. And the term for design, registered design, is 10 years. You can extend it up to the 15 years by paying the specific fees. So today we'll discuss about the registration process of design. So basically, who can claim the registration, or where you can file the registration application that we are going to discuss. So basically, registration of design is done by the Patent Office at Calcutta. The procedure of registration is contained in section number 5 and 10 of the Design Act and the rules that gives us a simple procedure. Basically, there are 10 steps they have involved. So who can claim the registration, or who can file the application for the registrations of design? So these are the 10 steps to file the application. So before this, just we'll take the brief. In a brief, we'll see what exactly happens. So so any person, it is claimed to be the proprietor of any new and original design which are not previously published in any country, that may be applied for the registrations of the design. We have seen the requirement. What are the requirements of the industrial design? That is, it must be new and novel. It must be applied on any specific article. It must be appealed to the eye. And the important thing of industrial design is that it should not be published any other countries prior to the publication in India, or prior to the filing the application under the Design Act. So for the purpose of this particular registration of industrial design, these goods or whatever the design that are classified under the 32 classes that I have already discussed, it is called as a Lacorno classification. So here
This is the Lacan classification system they have given. Just one. So here, these are the different 32 classes are there. Like a class 1 which contains the foodstuff, class 2 contains articles of clothing and haberdasheries, class 3 will be the travel goods, case and personal belongings. So likewise, the class 4 that will be the brushware. So if you have to register your design for any travel goods, which for consider about suitcase, so you have to file your applications under the class 3 where travel goods are there. If you want to take the designs of any brush, so you have to file under the class 4. For the pharmaceuticals and the cosmetic product, there is a class 28 where you can register any design. Means most of the times leaflets are there, or the outer designs of your bottle or important designs will be there, so that you have to register under the class 28, that is the pharmaceuticals and the cosmetic products and the toiletry article. So these are the different 32 classes, and another one important class is the 33rd class, that is miscellaneous class is also there. So which is present under the third sections of our design act. So where these 32 classes are there, so there will not be we can say for the purpose of the registrations, we have to select first class. So that step that we are going to discuss, in that these are the 10 steps to file the applications are there. Where importantly, first we have to decide whether or in which class you are going to take the registrations. So you have to file the applications. You have to make the statement of the novelty claims, like the claims you have made under the Patent Act. Then again the same thing, you have to give the evidence also. You have to create that designs in the 2D or the 3D form, and then you can file the application. So these are the 10 steps to file the applications. We'll discuss one by one. So what is the first step here? First we have to perform the pre-registration search, like a patent where we are performing the prior art search. Like the same way here we are performing the pre-registration search. So you have to find out whether any registration is already exists for that particular design or not. As I have already discussed, the term for your registration, industrial design registration is 10 years. After 10 years, you can extend up to the 5 years by paying the prescribed fees. If you are not paid, or suppose your registration is lapsed, so that will be available for the public use. So you will not file the case against those who are using your designs and all those things. But the same thing, before the filing the applications, you have to check that whether this particular design is published anywhere in India or outside the India. So you have to fill the form number 5 with the prescribed 500 rupees fees, and you can ask for the register also. So where means after paying the specific fees, means the controller have the rights to distribute the signed copy or the registered copy, signed copy of the registered industrial design register, where you can check whether this particular design is already registered or not. So this is the first steps to carry out the registration. So the inspection of registered design can be carried out. So you have to pay the prescribed fee, that is the 500 rupees. You have to pay the, you have to submit the form number 5. So any person that can obtain a certified copy of registered for the payment of the prescribed fees, and you can carry out the pre-registration search. Then the second, that is the preparing the representations of the design. So you have to prepare on a A4 size paper with a double margins, and you have to prepare the designs either in a 2D form or either in a 3D form, the sketch of your design, the representations of the representations of a design, the dimensions of designs you have to give there. how it will look on all the way. Means like a front view, rear view, for all those things, all those views you have to represent on that particular pages. So that means, and that drawing, what we have drawn on that particular paper, should be clearly define the features of the designs. So the angles of design that you have made or that you have created, or suppose it will be any 2D graphic designs will be there. So how it will look after applying on that specific article, that also you have to provide it. Suppose if there any bend will be there, so what will be the curve of that bend, that all the designs, if you are using any textures or color combinations, how it will look the color combinations also. So that all the designs you have to prepare on a A4 size paper with a specific margin. They are given like when you are drafting the claim, they have also given the page layout, how to draft that particular claim. So likewise, you have to, after pre-registration search, you have to prepare the representative designs which you are going to register under the Indian Design Act. Then you have to identify the class of the design. Just now I have discussed about the Locarno classifications. Basically, this is the Locarno agreement which will held in Locarno at 1968, where this particular foodstuff means the various articles are there that are divided into 32 different classes. So you have to select the class according to your means where your applications or where your registered designs will be applied. So basically, for the purpose of the registrations, as I already discussed, these goods are classified into the 32 classes. For the pharmaceutical and the cosmeceutical purpose, class 28 will be there, and depending upon that, so like material that can be used for the traveling purpose, means bags are there, means again now in a bag there will be the sub classes also. So likewise, there are 32 classes. Just now we are seeing these 32 classes. So you have to select the first class, and after selecting the class, you can register your applications under that class. Then you have to provide a statement of novelty, like a claim we are providing, right? So in a claim, we know there will be preamble, a phase, then body, and a closing statement will be there. They are, so likewise, you have to make the statement about your novelty. So the application, you have to, when you are submitting the application, that may be supported on the applications of the brief statement that a brief statement of the novelty he claims for the design. Means suppose you are claiming for any mobile design, suppose. So we have to give in a such a way that this particular novelty resides in this particular mobile phone surface pattern is illustrated as below design. So likewise, you have to make the statement about the novelty. कि तुमच्या त्या पर्टिक्युलर अशामध्ये नॉवेल्टी कशी आहे. सो दॅट हॅज टू बी गिवन इन अ स्पेसिफिक वेज. मीन्स फॉर वन एक्झाम्पल, वी कॅन से सपोज बुक शेल्फ विल बी देअर. सो नॉवेल्टी दॅट रिसाइड्स इन द शेप ऑर अ कॉन्फिग्युरेशन इन द बुक शेल्फ ॲज इलस्ट्रेटेड ॲज बिलो. ऑर सपोज नॉवेल्टी रिसाइड्स इन द ऑर्नामेंटल सर्फेस पॅटर्न्स ऑफ द फुटबॉल or any other objective. So likewise, you have to claim that novelty, and on that novelty only you will get the benefit or you will get the registration, because as we have already discussed, the requirement of your registering the industrial design, that it should be distinguishable from the others, right, or the others designs. So you have to claim accordingly what you are using, which shape you are using, or which type of ornament you are using, or which type of pictures you are giving. So you have to give the detailed information regarding that designs also. Then you have to include a disclaimer. If design is like to be confused with the trademark sometimes. It will happen. So you have to give the disclaimers, disclaimer about that particular designs. Then you have to claim the priority date from the 6 month of the file of applications, like your patent. We are asking for the claim a priority date also. So likewise, you can take the you can ask for the priority date in patent applications. Within a 12 months, you can ask for the priority date. But here, the time is 6 months from the priority date. What is the priority date? This is the date at which your actual examination is carried out of your applications. So, that is the important thing here, that you have to ask for the priority date. Then you have to pay the fees. Means for the registrations, it is 1000 fees is there for the Indian system, and for the renewal purpose, it will be the 2000 rupees. Means with the help of all the, you have to ensure all the enclosures or disclosures are attached properly, and you have to submit the applications at the under the design at Kolkata, or directly you can submit at the WIPO. Then suppose if any objections are there initially from the controller, then you have to comply the objections. And last step, that is, you have to provide the full details and submit the applications at Industrial Design Office at Kolkata. Okay, so these are the 10 steps prior to the filing the application. The important steps here, first is you have to carry out the pre-registration search. For that purpose, you have to file the form number 5, and you have to you will get a registered copy of your industrial design. So where you can carry out the pre-registration search whether this particular design is already registered or not. Then you have to identify the class of the design. Means under out of 32 classes, your design belongs to which class, that you have to first identify. And you have to provide a statement of the novelty, what novelty is including in your designs, that must be distinguishable from the others. Then only your applications will be go for the further step. And the remaining step that will be remain same as our patent application system. So this is the basically things that we have to remember while while filing the application under design act. Now this will discuss the actual process of the industrial design. So which is the same process as a patent application. Basically, when we are discussing all those things like copyright processing or like trademark processing, that will be the same as our patent. You have to first file the applications. You have to ask for the priority date. Then examinations will be there. After the examinations, there will be first examinations report will be sent to the applicant. You have to clarify the objections by the controller. If you satisfied with the your answers, then the registration will be granted. So same process here that is carried out. So first you have to submit the verified registration form along with the prescribed fees and 4 copies of the design representation that you have to submit. So here you have to submit the form number 1, that is the application form for the registrations of the designs with 1000 rupees of fees. There are different forms are there. Form 2 that will be used for the claim for the joint applications. Form number 3 will be the application for the extensions for copyrights. Form 4 will be the application for the restorations of lab design. Form 5 for the inspections of the registered design. And form 6 will be when the request for information when registration number is given. And form 7, when registration number is not given, you can request for the information. Then form 8 will be there for filing the petitions to cancel the registrations. And likewise, there are various forms are there. Since 2015, e-filing system is available. So this is the simple process that we are going to discuss. So you have to first submit the you need file registration form, as we have already discussed the steps you have take or you have to carry out before the filing the applications. You have to carry out the pre-registration search. You have to carry out. You have to prepare the specimen design. Means prepare the different designs. You have to check. Then you have to identify the class and all those things. After that, you have to prepare an applications. Then you have to submit it to the design wings of the patent office in Kolkata or any other branches. Or you can directly submit it to the WIP. So submit it to the design wings of the patent office in Kolkata or to any branch office of patent office, either in Mumbai, either in Delhi, or either in Chennai. So at the patent office, on the receipt of the applications, the application number is taken and date of application is mentioned here. So at the patent office, the application is numbered and dated and taken up for the examination purpose. So unlike the patent, no need to request for the examination. They will directly carry out the examination process here. So if any defect will be there, or if the controller found and the controller is not satisfied with the corrections and the personal hearing, then the personal hearing is given to the applicant. So again, the same thing like a first examination report, the controller cues what are the activities are there that you have to overcome in a specific time duration. Then suppose controller is not satisfied still with the personal with the corrections, a personal hearing will be there, and again the same thing, hearing will be carried out. Then you have to correct the defects or whatever the corrections are given by the controller within a period of the 6 months from the official date of the applications. So this is the time duration you have to follow. Basically means after filing the complete application, you can ask for the priority date within a 6 months. Then after submitting, after primary examinations, if any ambiguity will be there, if any defects will be there, so within a 6 months you have to corrected that defected, and again you have to file the applications. Then if the control is not satisfied, again the same thing, the personal hearing will be there. Then after the hearing, if the controller's decision is communicated to the applicant in a written, then applicant can appeal to the High Court against the controller decisions within the 3 months of the decisions. Once accepted, the application is notified. Application is accepted, it is notified in a patent office journal, and this will be registered under the Indian registered or the industrial registration. Sorry, under the Design Act, and in registered, this particular design is registered with the help of with the name of that specific applicant. So that is a simple process like a patent filing process. But here, pre-grant and post-grant oppositions are not there like a patent. Here, we have to correct the objections given by the controller itself. So that we have to take in mind. So first step, you have to file the applications. Where you are going to file the applications? At the design wing of the patent office in Kolkata. Aapla patent office se head branch kuthe aahe? Kolkata la. Tyachyamadhye design sathi, industrial design sathi specific wings hai. So tya particular design wings madhye patent office has also been filed karu shakta kiwa any other sub branch of patent office like in Mumbai or Chennai or Delhi. So once you file the applications, at that time you will get the application number and the date of applications. Then if any defects are there, it is communicated to the applicant, means after the examinations, and you are within a 6 months you have to answer the defects given by the controller. And if the controller is not satisfied with that particular corrections, then the personal hearing will be given. And after the hearing, the controller decides whether to register this particular industrial application industrial design or no. So this is the simple process that you have to follow to register. Now the fees I have already discussed. For application purpose you have to pay the 1,000 rupees fees. For the joint application purpose you have to pay the 500 rupees fees. For the extension purpose you have to file the 2,000 rupees fees for the renewal purpose. Likewise for the registrations of the labs design you have to file the 1,000 rupees fees. For the inspection of the register design before the pre-registration step. Pre-registration search step मध्ये जर तुम्हाला registered हवं असेल so you can pay the 500 rupees fees along with the form number 5 you will get the registered copy. So this is a simple process with that. Now we'll see about the rights of the controller. What the different rights are there for the controller. So first right under the section 8 substitutions of the applicant. So during the pendency of an applications the controller may substitute the name of the applicant by any person who has a satisfactory established claim to the design by assignment or the agreement. So the controller has right to substitute the name of the applicant if anyone can fulfill the requirements for the registrations of your design. Then the register of design, that is the important thing here. So the register of designs that will contain the particular of registered proprietor and the registered design. There are notifications of the assignment or the transmissions of the registered design. Means suppose I have given my design to someone else for their pleasure purpose. So their information or their notifications are also there. Another matter. And any other matter that I have described. Nowadays the register that is maintained in computer copy or the this particular register of design is a prima facie evidence if any matter entered in a code. So suppose in an infringement cases. So this will be this register will be the prima facie evidence that this particular design is registered under the Industrial Design Act 2000. So if anyone have infringed your designs or use your design without your permissions, so you can file the case against that particular person. Now obviously this particular register is open to the public inspections with a specific fees you have to pay. Then you can get a certified copies of entries in the register that can be available for the public use. Now there are some cases where the cancellations of registration, the register can be cancelled. These are the special rights that are given to the controller. So any person that is interested may present a petition to the controller for the cancellations of the registration of the design on various grounds, like if the design has been previously registered in India or that it has been published in India or any other countries prior to date of the registrations, and already we have discussed if the design is not new or not original design, so that design is not registerable under the Act. So where the cancellation process, where the application gets cancelled by the controller itself. Then there is a power of controller to rectify the register also. The controller may rectify the register on the publications in a prescribed manner by any person in respect of the some manners like non-insertions of any omissions of any entry or any entry made without sufficient causes or any wrongly means entered entries are there into the registers, or suppose any error or defect in any entry if you find, then he has to write to rectify the register also. That particular rectifications of registered that may be by way of the explaining of or varying any such entries, or sometimes Controller has power to decide any questions that are necessary or expedient in concerns with the rectification. So that all these rights have reserves to the controller. Another one important, that is the restorations of lapsed designs. So suppose if the registration is not renewed in a prescribed manner, means 10-year time duration will be there, and you have not renewed your applications or that particular registration, means after the expiration of the 10 years from the date of registration, then your registrations will be lapsed and ceased from that date. Then the registered, if suppose the registered proprietor may make an application for the restorations of the lapsed designs in a prescribed manner within the prescribed time, then suppose the controller is satisfied that the failure of paying the fees or failure of renovation was not unintentional, and that there has been no undue delay in the making of the applications. So by making the full payments or making the payment of all fees, your registrations will be restored, and it will be effective from the that date only. So suppose if anyone misuse your design in specific that durations, means after the lapse date to the next new date, then you cannot file any case against that particular applicant. So like a same patent registrations, if you have not renewed in a specific, or if you have not paid the renewal fees, so anybody can use your invented product, and that at that time you cannot take any legal actions against that particular person. Now the last part of Industrial Design Act, what will happen if increments of registered designs will occur? So the Design Act refers only to the piracy of registered designs, which is in substance as the same infringement, same as the infringement of the copyrights in the designs. So what are the different cases will be there, or what are the remedies are there that we are going to discuss? So basically, suppose if someone has applied or your registered designs to any class of the board without your permissions, or suppose any imitations will carried out, so that may be comes under the infringements. Or suppose any import of your design for the purpose of the sale of any article that belongs to the specific class in which the design has been registered, so this particular thing also comes under the infringements. Also suppose your registered design is published or exposed to the for sales of any articles of the class, any question to which the designs or the fraudulent or the obvious imitations is occurred. So these such cases are cases of infringements will take place. Now the main important thing is that the task of the judge is when you are filing the case for your infringement. So the task of the judge is to look at the two articles, means the original one and whatever the copying one or the imitating ones, to observe the similarities as well as the differences also. So to see, they have to see them together as well as separately, to bear in mind that in the end of the questions whether the design of the defendant's article is substantially different from that of the plaintiff, means judge koni complaint ke that he design आणि त्याच्या अगेन्स्ट कंप्लेंट झाली, त्याची डिझाईन ही सायमल्टेनियसली ऑब्झर्व केली, त्याच्यामध्ये कोणता चेंजेस आहे किंवा ती सिमिलर आहे का, कुठे टेक्स्चर डिफरंट आहे का, किंवा कुठे ऑर्नामेंटल डेविएशन कुठे आहे का. सो ऑल दोज थिंग्स दॅट दे हॅव टू चेक, अँड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दॅट द डिसिजन्स विल बी गिव्हन बाय द कंट्रोलर. सो दॅट इज द मेन टास्क ऑफ द जज व्हाइल गिव्हिंग द decisions. So against the plaintiffs or against the applicant also. So there are some civil remedies are also there against the infringements of the copyright designs. So first will be an injunctions, that will be the judicial
order they can use, or they can ask for the damage or the compensation purpose. Also delivery upon receiving articles. So basically injunctions will be temporary or the permanent. There is no provisions for the criminal proceedings against the piracy of designs like a jail or all those things. So under the interlocutory injunctions, the principle applicable to the grant of the interlocutory injunctions in the case of the designs are that are the same that are applicable in the case of the patent. Only the imprisonments will not be there. So suppose if plaintiff should make out prima facie case and show that the balance of the convenience is in his favor, then there will be interlocutory injunctions may not be granted, where the plaintiffs can be monetarily compensated in the event of his success in the action. Suppose ekada plaintiff to tumcha जे काही कंपन्सेशन वगैरे केलं असेल, तुमची केस फाईल केली जाऊ शकत नाही, जर तो तयार असेल की तुमच्या म्हणजे काही डॅमेज झाले किंवा जे काही तुमचं कंपन्सेशन असेल की तुम्ही त्याच्यामध्ये गेलो. सो द प्लेंटिफ, प्लेंटिफ इन द सेन्स पर्सन टू ब्रिंग द केस अगेन्स्ट अ अनदर पर्सन, फिर्यादी म्हणतो आपण इन मराठी वर्ड. सो इफ द प्लेंटिफ सक्सीड्स इन द ऍक्शन्स, द डिपेंडंट इज लायबल टू द पे by the way of compensations of sum of rupees 25,000 for each of the three categories of the infringements, means like commercial application of the designs of the article or importations of the articles or publication for the sales of the infringing articles. So in these three cases you have to pay the fine of 25,000 rupees and max to max 50,000 rupees that we have to pay. So if the proprietor elects to bring a suit for the injunctions and recovery of the damage, the amount of damage may be assessed on the same basis as in the patent cases. Means जेव्हा आपण patent cases मध्ये ज्या division मध्ये झालो असतो की application मध्ये तर त्यांनी design utilize करून किती amount मध्ये माझा loss झालाय. So that loss that you have to calculate it. But there is another one thing. It should not be more than 50,000 rupees. So, what are the remedies are there? You have to pay first, that is 25,000, and then max to max 50,000 if you require for the damage or the compensation purpose. So this is all regarding the Indian patent. So these are the Locarno classifications. These are 32 classes are there, under which these different articles or materials are divided. On the basis of that, where you are going to apply your designs, you have to select the first class here out of the 32 classes. And suppose any article not belongs to these particular 32 classes, you can means there is another one class, the miscellaneous class, so that all the articles are covered under the that particular classes. So this is all regarding the industrial design. So what we have covered till now, just we'll take a brief review about the industrial design act or the industrial design. What is industrial designs? So the designs, that means only the features of shapes, configurations, patterns, ornament or compositions of the lines or color which is applied to any articles, whether in a two-dimensional or three-dimensional or in a both form, by any industrial process or by means, whether either manual process, either mechanical process or any chemical process, separately or the combinedly, which is in the finished article, which will appeal to the eye and that is solely judged by the eyes. But that particular industrial design does not include any mode of principle of constructions or anything which is in a substance of or a mere mechanical device, that is called the design. For this design act, we have discussed design act also. So design act, what is the year of design act? When it comes in a force?
Yes, anyone? What is the year of Desire Act? Yes, anyone? आठ लेक्चर लगे गेला सो अंडर डिजाइन एट 2000 फॉर विच वर कम्स इन फोर्स इन 11th मे 2001 द डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर देयर दैट वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस देन दीस आर द सम केसेस वेयर द डिजाइंस आर नॉट रजिस्टर्ड That means it must be new or original. It should not be published anywhere in India or in other countries by at the time of filing registration. It must be distinguishable from the others and it should not be contain any scandalous or the obvious matters. These are the requirement and these are the things that are not registerable and These are the steps that are involved, you know, filing the applications under the Design Act for registering your designs. This is the process, and here are the rights of controllers. And this is the case. What will happen? If implement will be there under the Indian Design Act. So here our second topic is completed. We'll conduct the test on both the topic under the Indian Patent Act and. Under the Design Act on Wednesday or Thursday, which will be possible to do after the ending of your three lectures. Means at the end of your daily schedules, we'll arrange one test on these two topics.